It's the National Football League on EA Sports, and the wait is over for this rivalry game. It's the Packers and the Bears, and it's coming up next.
Soldier Field opened back in 1924 with the Bears becoming tenants in 71, and what a home field advantage it has become here in Chicago. Just a short time ago, this crowd loud enough to shake the foundations of this nearly century-old building. They are ready for football indeed in Chicago as their guys get set to do battle with Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And CD, you look at the Packers in this matchup.
It's going to be a big-time battle, and I think that both of these teams have that mindset of, we're going to do what we do and make the other guys react to us. And we've definitely got a couple of headstrong coordinators who won't back down from a challenge. So this will be a battle of wits as much as it'll be a battle of brawn.
It's a rivalry that dates back to 1921. The Packers and Bears are underway from Chicago. And we will not get a run back here to start. It's a touchback, and it will come out to the 25. Now we get a look at Aaron Rodgers as he gets set to lead this Green Bay Packer offense. Rodgers now in his 17th season in the league, and of course, coming off the MVP trophy.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
On first down, Rodgers. Open man left side, it's the tight end, Tonyan. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Pass, catch, first down for Tonyan. Undrafted at Indiana State, but he really came on in 2020. 52 catches, and even more importantly, 11 touchdowns.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Got a man, that's Lazard. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. So the penalty declined, and they will keep the yardage on the completion.
And you could almost see him compartmentalize there throughout the route. Fought hard into line of scrimmage, a lot of hand-checking throughout the route. Great job staying focused on the football and pulling it in through the contact.
On play action, it's Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
And another nice catch there for a first down by Devontae Adams. That's something we're quite familiar with. Last year, the NFL leader in touchdown catches with 18, tied for second in receptions, fifth in receiving yards, added all up, arguably the top receiver in the NFL.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 right at the 20. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Credit the tackle for loss to Robert Quinn.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to
see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels. Because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Here's Jones again on second down. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 13 on the play, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. No score after one on EA Sports. The Packers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they go to work on a first and goal. Dylan. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
It's a nice second effort we just saw there. I saw him trying to get to the end zone, but a lot of times near the goal line, that second effort can lead to disaster. Make sure you hold on to the football because there's going to be guys swarming when you're carrying it.
Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. Again, it'll be Dylan. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Play number 8 here on the opening drive. This is third and goal. Here's Rodgers to throw. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured bear on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. The kick by Crosby is good, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that, and this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. For the first time, here comes the Chicago Bear offense, led out by the veteran in his first season in Chicago, but 11th overall, the Red Rifle, Andy Dalton.
And the first possession isn't until the second quarter, but what's nice about it, it's only down three. So what you sell your team on is, look, one possession, one drive, we put it in the end zone, we're in the lead in this game. Let's go, guys.
Dalton, first and 10. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Well, they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
It's almost not fair when you talk about Allen Robinson to talk about how dependable he is, but that's a great word for him. Last year, first time he's gone over 100 receptions in his career, and he makes a nice catch there for a first down.
Going for the deep ball. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Darnell Mooney, the target there. And now it's second down.
I believe I'm following their logic. Take the big shot downfield, loosen things up. You're hoping to get some points on the board before the half. Maybe now you come back and throw some underneath stuff in order to make sure you get a completion.
To throw on second and 10, Dalton. Under heavy pressure, and down goes Dalton on the sack. Rashawn Gary, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six.
It seemed like he kept going through those progressions, and I thought he might dump that underneath, but he couldn't get rid of the football in time.
And I have to wonder if he was thinking while he was back there, I wish there were a lot less progressions on this play, just someone that I can dump the ball to and get it out of my hands.
Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. And right side, they're going to go option here. And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. The Packers with a football here late in this first half. And you wonder if they'll just take this 3-0 lead to the locker room. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Here's Rodgers. And his throw here is incomplete. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. He finds Funchess. Fighting his way through contact. And down to the 20.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
Well, we know that he can beat you in a number of ways. He can catch it short, he can take it longer, he can do what we just saw right there, catch it and then run with a football.
Yeah, and this is what we mean when we talk about flipping the field, having your offense look at going a long way to a short way after he makes a play. His ability to do that, evident. Able to make the catch there, keep his momentum going, and just continue downfield.
And the next-gen stats show us the tale of how much yardage he was able to tack on after the catch.
Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. To Valdez-Scantling over the middle. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Throwing now is Rodgers. And that one going to be off target and incomplete. Robert Tonyan, the intended target, but it'll be second and goal.
That was a nice job defensively of disguising their coverage and making it difficult for the quarterback to lock in on a receiver, and it results in an incomplete pass.
The line of scrimmage once again, the five, as they get ready for second and goal. And again, it's Rodgers. Got a man open, it's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further.
That was quite the call down around the goal line on fourth and goal.
Yeah, they faked the run, pull it out, throw it. And as a defense, I've been in that spot before, and we see it all the time. You almost have.
Now, I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. Five plays there on that drive, and it ends with a Packers touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. And
the Bears going to get one more possession in this first half. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go.
A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground.
Space to maneuver at the 40. And he takes it all the way up to the 47. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Now Dalton with a first and 10. This is caught by Robinson. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
Come on, baby. Let's go.
Yes, sir. Spotlight, baby. That's it.
So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. We got an excellent first half from the former MVP, Mr. Aaron Rodgers. First up, though, a look at the next-gen stats for the Packers in that first half. And their offense has been in top form so far, especially their passing game, as it's helped push them out to this big halftime lead. Meanwhile, for the Bears, we check on their numbers on the ground in the first half, as they know they'll need to be better to overcome this halftime deficit.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Bears going to see the football first, and they trail here as we get back underway to start this second half. And we will not see a return to start the half, as this will be a touchback. The Bears offense set to go to begin the third quarter. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive, because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
I'm ready to take over, baby. Stay. Lady!
On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Out of the gun, running with Cohen. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
Hey, Mike, 51.
Passing, it's Dalton. He'll leave it for Montgomery, complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down. Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. Za'Darius Smith able to get him down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. And we've got movement. I think this is against the Bears here. Let's find out. Oh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
Still second down.
A false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Soldier Field. It's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Dalton. And this is incomplete.
We're going to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Throwing, Dalton. Throw left side, complete to Bird. They get six, that'll leave them with third and four.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's gonna line up out right, then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
This will be the eighth play of the drive here, third and four. And Dalton to throw. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he will have the Bears first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting seven there on third and four. That one good for seven as this long drive continues and the chains move again. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Dalton operating in the red zone now. There's Mooney with another catch. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Dalton saying, let's get going here, guys, as he rallies him to get set. Dalton. Incomplete. Joshua Jackson there to knock that one away.
Passing lanes tough to come by with so many defensive backs on the field here late in the game. And it's not just the number of bodies, It's their quickness and their agility that makes it tough to complete a pass.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Now Dalton. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
So the field goal got him back within one score, and now the focus lies on this onside kick. And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers hands team. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that one. They needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it, but even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all three timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. First down carry by Jones, and he's able to get this one down to about the 40. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll go again to Jones. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Rodgers, and that is incomplete.
Whether that's a little grabbing, a little hand fighting, by any means necessary on third down, he was able to get the job done in the secondary and swat that one away.
Here's J.K. Scott now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And they won't try and pooch it. It's a fake. And the fake will work. He's going to have a first down. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 1:06 left to go in the game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. The Packers looking to get out of here with a win as they take the knee. Rodgers will take a knee here, and that should be all she wrote.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I've feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair. Low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art, but maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. Well, Charles, the old saying, the old cliche, if you will, points at a premium. That certainly applied here, didn't it?
And that almost felt like opened up a time capsule, didn't it? Old school football, low scoring, close game. What a way to finish it up.
You loved it, didn't you?
I certainly did.
You loved the defenses.
I certainly did. Brought back the images of the game of old.